Monday or be punished with in-school suspension.
He's got his haircut like this for 6 months. Now all of a sudden, it's a problem. Where he had a space here and a space there.
They're like, fix it. But what y'all want him to do? Shave his head? Don't want him to like glue his hair back? Don't want him to wear a weave? What do you want this boy to do? How are you gonna fix it? Y'all gonna have to wait until it grows back.
He took a Sharpie permanent marker and colored the bottom of his hair. So, in order for him to get an education, we have to treat his hair like a coloring book, I guess.
Wow! So, to fix it, they took a Sharpie. Why are you gonna take a Sharpie of all the things you could cover it with? They got sprays for, like, gray hair that you could, like, spray on. I'm pretty sure they could, like, spray it on his head. Jeez. This is traumatizing. Imagine getting suspended for your haircut. Bye, bitch! Y'all don't want me here? I'm gonna leave.
Letters, symbols, and designs beyond a single straight line which draw attention to an individual shall not be permitted.
Okay, hold up. He doesn't even have letters, symbols, or a design. He got a straight line. It says beyond a straight line. Is it because he had two straight lines? Like, one straight line is okay? What do you want this boy to do? This is ridiculous, man. Next up, this kid got suspended for wearing a hoodie. Okay, I'm good. I ain't got a hood. I ain't in school either. This doesn't apply to me. Suspended for a hoodie? Damn, might as well suspend the whole school.
Penn Hill students are speaking out tonight after dozens were suspended for wearing hoodies to school. Hoodies are banned, but some say there's a reason for wearing them.
Dozens? I feel like the teachers just don't want to go to work. We can't go to work if all our students are suspended. Let's just suspend everybody.
The Penn Hill School District suspended dozens of students for various dress code violations. Now, I had the chance to speak to one of those students today. He wasn't in school because he says he took the risk of wearing a hoodie despite the district's new dress code policy.
New dress code policy, no hoodies. So if I wear a sweater without a hood, it's okay? I need to know.
My first suspension is because of a hoodie.
This is the hoodie that got 18-year-old Chris Dixon suspended from school on Friday.
Oh, excuse me, young man. What does this hoodie say? It's all starting to make sense now. Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
Well, in the school, you get suspended for supporting the school. Call a bunch of students down to talk to us in the cafeteria and suspended us for the dress code violation. The majority of us was because of hoodies.
The school suspended students for wearing a hoodie that the school sells. What? That's like y'all buying my merch and then I ban you from watching my videos. What the fuck?
The policy states that students may wear garments with hoods to school, but must remove them and place them in lockers or bags once school begins.
So if it's cold in the class, you can't wear a hoodie, you can't wear a jacket. Like, bitch, I'm cold. Classrooms are like 60 degrees. What do you want me to do? Why? With only a hood. What if I tuck the damn hood in my shirt? People out here getting suspended over this. There are people dying out there. There are people getting suspended over wearing a hoodie.
A garment with a hood presents a unique concern, both in regard to safety and disruption of the educational process.
Oh my god, Jake over there. We are doing a part two of kids who got suspended for no reason. Leave a like if you are out of school or almost done. So somebody sneezed and then a girl said bless you. And she got suspended. I'm allergic to this bullshit.
A senior at Dyer County High School, she says that her teacher disciplined her after she said bless you when one of her fellow classmates sneezed.
Bro, imagine being a senior in high school and getting in trouble for saying bless you. What?
Was taking issue with her religion. When she stood up for herself, Turner says she was told to go to the administrator's office and later placed an in-school suspension
over blessing someone who was sneezing. I don't know how somebody could be offended by this.
Esther tells me students had just talked about how to stand up for their faith last week in church.
There were several students that were talking about this particular faculty member there that was very demeaning to them in regards to their faith.
So, let me get this straight. The teacher got offended when somebody said, bless you, because it's a religious thing? Like, she's offended? What? Oh, no. It gets worse.
Student sent me this picture. It shows a list of words the student claims the teacher does not allow in the classroom.
So the teacher deadass has a list of words that you can't say. You're not allowed to say stupid, dumb, boring stuff. What the hell? What wrong, they'd say, I don't know. Bless you is on the list. Does that say hang out? Hey, man, you want to hang out and do homework later? What is wrong with this teacher?
A student sent me this picture. It shows a list of words the student claims the teacher does not allow in the classroom. You can see bless you is on the list. Turner's parents tell me school leaders claimed the outburst was a classroom distraction, that Turner shouted bless you across the room.
You know, that's what kids do. Somebody sneezes, somebody is gonna yell bless you. I don't care if it's during a test, I don't care if it's while she's teaching. It's just common etiquette. I don't know. This next one, this girl got suspended for exposing her nasty ass school.
A student snaps a picture, posts it to social media, but then gets suspended for it.
Suspended for posting a bathroom picture. Leave a like if you took a picture in your school bathroom and got away with it. Because apparently it's not allowed in some schools.
Hazel Juco says when she saw discolored water coming from the sink at school, it upset her.
I just took a picture of it, and then fourth hour is my newspaper class, and I went and talked about it with them.
What the fuck? Y'all see that water? That ain't water. That's straight piss. It's like whatever you put in the toilet, it's coming out. And they want you to just shut up and wash your hands with it. The school's probably like, that's why you got soap, dumbass. Obviously, anybody who sees this is going to take a picture. There is something wrong. Y'all need to fix this. It's doo-doo water.
She posted the picture on Facebook and Twitter. Why?
I always hope that, like, something good will happen. We'll somehow have someone who wants to help us with money, because our school obviously doesn't have money.
She gonna call it out like that. My school obviously doesn't have money, so, like, someone gonna help out or not? Can we talk about how good her makeup's looking right now? Like, girl, you tell me you go to school every day like this?
A short time later, she got called down to the office at John Glenn High in the Wayne Westland School District.
She told me that I was being suspended for 3 days, OSS, for taking a picture. It's inappropriate use of electronics in the restroom.
You're telling me everybody can just take a selfie in the bathroom. It's not because she exposed the school for having doo-doo-ass water. It's because she took a picture in the bathroom. Inappropriate use of electronics. What? 3 day suspension for that. There are people taking selfies and stuff.
And everyone in her school, every girl takes, like, selfies in the bathroom and makes it their profile picture on, like, Twitter or Facebook or whatever. And no one has gotten in trouble.
Exactly. What if you see somebody getting their ass beat in the bathroom? What if you see Thanos in your bathroom? No shit, you're gonna take your phone out and take a picture, record a video, something. You're gonna get suspended for inappropriate use of electronics.
Students protested by tweeting bathroom pictures they took without getting in trouble. For one, they didn't report the water issue to maintenance.
That's good. I like how everybody's, like, posting pictures like, ha, I didn't get suspended. Why don't you suspend me for posting a bathroom selfie? But now they're saying she should have reported the water issue instead of tweeting about it. Which, yeah, she should have reported it. But she should also tweet about it. Because why the hell not?
Dr. Honola says the rule against cell phones in bathrooms aims to prevent inappropriate pictures of people, not building issues. And the punishment is inappropriate.
So, the whole reason they have this rule is so you don't take a pic of somebody doing their business, but you're not allowed to take selfies either. But everybody's gonna take selfies anyway. And everybody's gonna use their phone in a bathroom anyways. Alright, this is really not making any sense, okay? I can't. These schools, they just, like, make up shit on the spot. So this 9-year-old boy got suspended. Bro, this dude's name is Ron Savage. Say something savage.
What are children safe? Everybody agrees with that. Does this toy look like a threat? The parents think the school is overreacting.
Brian, you do not live up to your name.
Gage has a cool toy. You wind it up and you spin it on the floor. And this spinning top also comes with what I call a winder-upper.
Bro, shut the hell up. It's a damn Beyblade. Y'all never heard of a Beyblade? I used to bring that to school all the time. We used to have an arena and we used to, like, race them. We used to flood and rip. That was my shit. I didn't know they still had them. But now, dumbass teacher's gonna be like, that's a gun. Poor kids, man. These innocent-ass kids playing with toys that I grew up with. And they're gonna get in trouble for this. Makes me sad.
So cool. Took it to school. Mom got a call at work.
Telling me that I have to come pick my son up from school, was playing with a toy and pointed it to a kid and was pretending it was a gun and said, bang, bang.
No, I'm gonna tell you right now, that's bullshit. I'm not buying it. No, it's a Beyblade. You let it rip. You don't bang bang it.
Schools have Gage is suspended indefinitely. Mom picked Gage up and says Gage and two other boys who were with him said Gage never said bang bang.
They suspended this poor little 9-year old playing with a toy. And they said, you didn't say bang bang. I called it. Y'all making this shit up.
One of the boys asked to see the toy, and Gage said sure.
Asked if he could see the toy, and then he started talking when I was about to give it to him, and I was like this.
Oh my God, Becky, did you see what that boy just did?
I was like this.
You better take that toy from him and suspend him. He gonna be a future gun user.
That's why my kid's getting suspended. His mom had called me and told me the situation. So I actually had to miss out on school because of this ridiculous situation.
He didn't even use it as a gun. That's what bugs me the most. Like, he was just doing something else. And one of the teachers got, like, hella triggered, like, is that a gun?
I don't see any reason, like, it doesn't look like a gun.
Actually, Gage and two other kids at the school had both told me that the words bang bang were never used.
Nobody said bang bang. His teacher probably thinking about the principal. The word is bang bang going through her head. And then she looked at him, and she saw the gun, she got hella triggered, and she thought about bang-banging the principal after school, and then accused the kid, and then he got suspended. Oh no! Becky, what have you done? Okay, this next one is really dumb. I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard about this on Twitter, but this girl got suspended for not wearing a bra, which is awful, because bras suck. I know if I was going to school every day, we came at 7 in the morning, I wouldn't want to wear a bra some days too. Shit's uncomfy. Imagine having a band around your rib cage and it's just squeezing and digging in. But it's like, if you don't wear it, then you got this problem. The ultimate school distraction.
A Bradenton family is questioning the Manatee County School District's dress code policy after their daughter was told to put band-aids on her breasts underneath her shirt.
So instead of giving her a bra, making her wear another shirt or something, they actually told her to put band-aids on her nips. Okay, that's a little...
17-year-old Lizzie Martin left for Brayton River High School Monday morning wearing this t-shirt and no bra. She says a dean saw her, thought it was inappropriate, and made her put a t-shirt on underneath this shirt.
What a thirsty ass dean. If he gonna see a high schooler not wearing a bra and be like, I don't! Is it hot in here? Or am I just thirsty? I would just not bring it up. That is just so embarrassing to even mention.
Lizzie says the dean still wasn't happy.
She asked me to stand up and move around for her. She then proceeded to tell me that it wasn't a fix. So we went to the clinic and she gave me band-aids in there and told me to X out my nipples.
What? Like those X's that strippers put on, but with band-aids. Bro, this is beyond messed up. This just sucks, man.
Humiliated with no choices, Brayden River High Junior Lizzie Martin did what she was told. She says the dean thought it was necessary because her braless shirt was distracting male students.
Bitch, it didn't distract anybody but you. She felt personally attacked. That's what just blows my mind. Like, a girl is gonna call out a girl for having what all girls and boys have.
The boys in my class were so distracted. Shouldn't they have been talked to or educated about, like, the situation and not me being pulled out of class?
This was a shirt that was unisex, that was too big, that was not form-fitting.
It'll use a big baggy shirt. Well, if I wear a big baggy shirt or like a hoodie or something, like most of the time I will not wear a bra. So like, I understand. Some girls, they just want to be like comfy. And that's what it comes down to.
And like, I'm not wearing a bra.
I am, because then I will get dress coded. I know YouTube would be hella quick to dress code. And by dress code, I mean demonetized.
Lizzie had to cover up to keep from embarrassment. But now school leaders are saying Lizzie violated the school dress code policy. But there are no rules about not wearing a bra.
Y'all gonna have to make up your mind. Which one? Did she violate the dress code? Or did y'all get offended?
They target a male who had excessive breast tissue and ask him to confine the movement.
She said it like it is. I know there are plenty of dudes out there that got excessive breast tissue. And I know you could see a little jiggle. You could see a little something, something, a little movement. They're not gonna say anything. These are all awful. Leave a like if you've never been suspended for any of these, because they're all bullshit. But if you have been suspended, comment below. Let me know for what. And let me know if you guys want more of these dumbest reasons that kids got suspended.
This sixth grader told to change his haircut by his school, and tonight his father wants to know why.
You're telling me this little boy got suspended from school because of his haircut. Man.
There's still time to find the perfect gift at Macy's last minute gift sale. With up to 60% off something they'll adore. It's your last chance to spend your Macy's money and pick up your orders, even gift cards, in-store or curbside. Now at Macy's.
To live with a progressive disease like ADPKD is to live with the knowledge that at any moment, the walls may start closing in.
The complete.
Are you for real?
Yeah.
That is an insane amount of money for a blanket. I can literally go to Walmart and get a blanket for $15. Then go to Walmart and get a blanket. Seriously? How the f*** did you get that price? For a blanket. You want a blanket that's 100% wool, not acrylic or anything artificial. That would come out to $160 then, not $140. Plus, craft stores are always having sales, so you could probably get the yarn for a lot less. The other $240 is for my time. That's insane. You're charging way too much. You want a wool blanket that is essentially queen size made of wool. Stitch will take me 120 to 150 hours. You're telling me charging less than $2 an hour is charging way too much? Other croquers can make it for so much cheaper than have it made by other croquers. You are insane. I can't believe you think $400 is a fair price. Blanket made. It's for my girlfriend. She's super ill and I want her to have something nice. That's unfortunate, but it's still going to cost you $400. You're insane. You should be giving me a friends and family discount or something since you took forever to respond to me. I charge friends and family more. I'll tell you what. Here's what we are going to do. You make the blanket. Get the yarn on sale. On sale only. When it's complete, I will pay you, but only when it's completed. I'll give you $70, which is more than generous. No! You pay me $200 up front and $200 upon completion. Then you pay shipping. What the f*** do I have to pay half up front? Because if you back out, I'm not $160 in the hole on yarn. No, you're going to buy the yarn on sale. Of course I'm going to buy the yarn on sale, but I'm still going to charge you full price. You're insane. I gave you a really generous offer. I'm going to report you. I'll make sure everyone knows of your scam. You're charging way too much. Way too much. Oh no, nobody will ever ask me to do a commission again. Don't do that. I am begging you. You're going to be out of business. Oh my gosh. Oh no, whatever will I do now? You don't believe me? Oh no, I do. I just don't care. I will destroy your business. Look at all the f*** I don't give. Dude, I don't have a business. I'm a flight instructor. Croquet is just my hobby. I take commissions on occasions, but I don't do croquet for an income. I don't even really want a commission that much. So if you really want the damn blanket, then that's what I'm charging. Then you should do it for free. You don't need the money. I'll tell you what, I'll do it for $800. You're telling me you want this person to work 120 hours to make you a blanket for free because they don't need the money. Yeah, man. Like, Bill Gates doesn't need money. He should just literally give out computers for free to everybody. Hello, friends. It's me. And today I'm here to give you your daily dose of cringe. When Batman reveals his true identity to the world. I've already seen the movies. I know what happened. Hey, wait a second. Who was that? I think Bruce Wayne? It's an imposter. Why are you looking at me like that? I ordered Batman from Wish.com. This is what I got.
Yeah, what's better than a wink? Three winks.
Thoughts are also violent. Okay. Nice.